So good morning to all of you. I welcome you to this lab session on RDBMS. In today's lab session, we are going to discuss the following topics, very important ones. And if you have your SQL command line open, that would be great so that you can work along with me. Otherwise, you can take the screenshots wherever you find it appropriate, you know. So this is the outline of today's lab session. We'll be learning how to create users in Oracle 12c and onwards. Why do I write Oracle 12c and onwards is because it is different as compared to versions prior to Oracle 12c. We'll see that, right? And those of you who have installed 11g or, you know, or 9i and all, they can see the difference here. Then after that, once users have been created, we can discuss privileges and roles in SQL. We'll also be discussing grant and revoke commands, commit, save point, and rollback in SQL. And if time permits today, then maybe alter table command in SQL. So this is the outline of today's lab session. Okay. So let's begin. Now, how do we create users in Oracle 12c? You see, the normal syntax for creating a user is create user, username identified by password. You people have worked with this in the lab. So let's first check the syntax of Oracle that we are using. Okay, so for that you can use this command. Okay, you can use this command to check the syntax. This is for syntax up to 4 decimal places. Okay, this is for syntax up to 4 decimal places. So I have started a SQL star plus session. I will connect to it. Okay. So you can see here Oracle Database Express Edition release. So if you want to see this version here, you can write this command and you can see it behaves exactly in the same way. Okay. Select banner from V$version where row num is equal to 1. So Oracle Database 18c Express Edition release 18.0.0.0. So up to 4 places of decimal, it will show the version, right? So let's try a basic create user command. Okay. So we have create user, say Z1 identified by Z1. So normally you see this command works prior to Oracle versions 12c. Let's see what it tells us here. It gives us an Oracle error ORA 65096 with a message invalid common user or role name. Okay, so this would be the problem in databases 12c and onwards. Otherwise, prior to 12c, if you write this command, it will create the user and you can work with the user. Okay, now let's see what we can do about it. So we have, you know, when we install Oracle 12c and onwards the installation, then two types of databases are there. One is the container database, CDB, also known as the root container, and then the pluggable databases. So while we install Oracle 12c and onwards, we install the database as a container database, that is as a CDB, okay? And you know, while we are creating a new user, it should be created in a pluggable container. If we don't create it in a pluggable container, then we have this error ORA 65096, which says invalid common user or role name. So what we are discussing here is, while we install Oracle 12c and onwards, the installation is done as a container database, as a CDB, okay? Whereas a new user should always be created in a pluggable database, in a PDB. So that's why this error is coming, because we are trying to create a new user while we are logged in or while our database is a CDB. Okay. And the message is an attempt was made to create a common user or role with a name that was not valid for common users or roles. So what solution do we have for this? One solution is that the common user and role names, they must begin with C. Just a second. Okay. They must begin with C double hash. Okay. whether uppercase or lowercase, and should consist only of ASCII characters. Okay, let me work this for you. Kindly keep on noting or taking screenshots, please, right? So I can write here, create user, say Z1, identified by Z1. This is the minimum syntax that you can go with. So you will say, it will say user created. Okay. So if you are creating a user while you are in a CDB, in a container database, which is the default, then you, the username must begin with C double hash. Okay. And then we can proceed further with the way that we need to work with this user. That I'll discuss. But you see, this would be very awkward, like beginning all our usernames with the C double hash. So what we can do here is, a solution to this is, let's see what solution do we have for this. You know, we can set, there is a hidden parameter, okay? There is a hidden parameter known as _oracle_script, okay? So to tackle this ORA 0659, I think it's a mistake here. Just a second. Yeah, 65096, I suppose. This error should be there, right? So the idea is to set this script value, that is to make it true, okay? So once you do that, okay, then you can create users without a C double hash, okay? This user will not be useful in a pluggable container database, okay? So like, you are creating this user by setting this Oracle script property to true, this would be useful only in CDB. It won't be transferable to a pluggable container, okay? So how you should set this parameter as true is with this command, alter session, set this equal to true. And then you can create a normal user syntax, create user username identified by password, okay? So let's do that. Let's copy this so that we can use it there. So let me just copy it here. Okay. So I'm saying I'm logged in as a user, as a system user, as a DBA. So I'm saying alter session set Oracle script to true. Okay. So the session is altered. Okay. Now if I create a user, say Z1 identified by Z1, this will work. Okay. So we have seen the differentiation between a container database and a pluggable database. And while we are in a container database, that is by default that we create an Oracle database as a container database, then if you need to create new users, it should begin with C double hash. But if you are adamant, no, I want to create this user without C double hash, then you can alter your session and you can set this Oracle script property to true. Okay. Once done, you can create users normally. Okay. So now what happens once a user is created? Suppose I want to connect as a user right now. Okay. I want to connect as Z1. Right now, if you see, I'm connected as system. Okay. I'm connected as system. So can someone tell me how I can connect as Z1 user? And whether it will give some problem to me? Can raise hands to answer this question. Yes. Yes, you can raise hands to answer this question. How I can connect, how I can log in as user Z1. You people have already done this thing, so I need not be telling you about it. Yes, Shivam. Shivam Gupta, are you there? Okay. Abhijit Kumar. Okay. Akshay Sharma. Yeah, Abhijit.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Abhijit, how can we log in as Z1?
मेरे को पता नहीं चल रहा है सर, मैंने जस्ट ज्वाइन किया है सर थोड़ा पहले।
ओके ओके फाइन, नो प्रॉब्लम्स। गौरव कुमार, यू कैन आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन। Gaurav, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Gaurav, can you tell me how I can log in as Z1?
Yes.
Why? You can't connect as a user? So we are on the verge of finishing RDBM. Sabko ye nahi pata abhi tak how we can connect as a
sir, connect.
Itna time kyun liya bolne mein? Answer to pata hai aapko. Chalo, connect likh dete hain. Then
सर यूजर नेम
स्लैश पासवर्ड कर दें।
यस सर।
सी व्हाट इट सेज, इट सेज यूजर Z1 lacks create session privilege, log on denied. कैन समवन टेल मी यू नो हाउ टू टेक केयर ऑफ दिस एरर? सो व्हाट इज रिक्वायर्ड यू नो सो दैट Z1 कैन log in? It's create session privilege. See, our today's topic is about privileges and roles also. Okay, right? So all the words you can see here that user Z1 lacks create session privilege. So while we created a user with this command, create user Z1 identified by Z1, we didn't give any create session privilege to it. Okay, so let's give it this privilege. So again, I need to connect as system. Okay. And I can give the password here. And then I can write here, grant, connect. Let me just first write these two privileges to Z1. Now, these are the roles. Okay, two things are there. Privileges are there. Roles are there. Roles are a group of related, you know, system privileges. Privileges is some authority which is given to a user. So for a user to log on, he must have this connect role or the connect privilege. If it is not given to him while the user is created, then the user won't be able to log in. Now this connect would ensure that a user can log in. And this resource would ensure that the user can create the various objects, tables, views. Okay, fine. So let's once again connect as Z1. Okay, I'm again connecting as Z1. So now you will see it says connected. Okay, and say let me now create a table first. Okay, look at all these things very carefully so that you can work with them later on. Create, I'll take a very small example. Create table, say Q, and then I can write a column as role and the type as number. So I've created a table. Okay. Now this, the resource privilege allowed me to create the table. Now let's see what happens when I insert values into this. Okay. So insert into Q. I'm inserting values. Okay, I'm inserting a roll number 10 into my table. See what it tells me. See, so it says no privileges on table space users. So you see, while a user has to create his objects, whether they are tables, whether they are views, he must have some space for that, which is known as a table space. Okay, so for all the users, there's a users table space, then there is a system table space, or we can create our own table space also. Right now, the user Z1 has got no table space. That's why this problem is coming. Okay. So let's once again, you know, connect as system to resolve this. Okay. Now I'll ask you a question. Okay. Create user. I'm creating a new user now. Create user. Say W1 identified by say W1, and I can say default table space say users. Okay, I'll go by parts. Okay, if I do this, let's see whether any table created by this user can add values or not. Very important, right? So let's do this. First of all, a question: will this work? Will this command work? I'm going to create a user without C double hash. Will this work? Because I have started a new session. Once I log out and I log in, it's a new session. So again, it will give me that 65096 error. Right? So again, what I need to do is I need to set that script variable to true. So you need to learn how to, you know, work with these things. So you can write here. Once this is done, now this command will work. And see whether this command lets us add values or not. Okay. Done. Now a user is created and he is associated with the tablespace users. Okay. Let's now again log in as this user. But before that, we must give him these basic things so that he can log in and create his objects. 2W1. I'm going slow so that you understand, all of you. Okay, and then I'll again connect as W1. So I've logged in. Let me again create a table. Say P. Again, one column with data type as number. And then again, I try to insert values into it. So insert into P values 10. Okay. See, still it says no privileges on tablespace users. Now the thing is, while I created this user here and associated, I said default tablespaces users, I didn't allocate any quota to this user that how much space he can use out of it. That was missing. Okay. So let's once again connect as system. Right? System. And obviously I need to again, I'm in a new session, so I must go like this. Okay. And then I can create, I can just copy this from here. Yeah, I can copy this. I can drop the user. Let's see where the drop user works. It was W1, right? Let's see if there is some problem here. Okay. Okay, so I've dropped the user W1. Okay. Take some time to drop. Yeah. Now I can again use the same user, create user W1, identify to W1 this, and then I can mention how much space out of that user's table space it can use. So I can write something like 2M on users. This means now that the user W1 has a password, W1 is connected with the tablespace users and he can use 2MB of that tablespace. Okay. So after that, the usual grant, let's grant him the two roles. This, remember, these two roles would mean that one connect, that means he can log in, and resource mean that he can do anything with his objects, create, insert, delete, and all the things, right? Okay, then once again, connect as W1. Okay, and then I can write here, create table. So I create this table, and then I can go with an insert statement here. So now the table is P. Okay. See now what I have done, right? So if I now select, you can see all the four values that I inserted. Okay. So remember the things that we have discussed about create user. First, that it should be in a pluggable database. But when we install Oracle 12c and onwards, it is always installed as a container database. So to create a user in a container database, you must begin the username with C double hash. If you don't want that, then you can just set a property that you can see on screen, alter session set Oracle underscore script underscore Oracle underscore script to true. Once done, you can create your users without any C double hash, preceding by C double hash. Then once a user is created, this would be a good user. Look at this command. This is the full command. You can see you must give a username and a password. Then you must give a tablespace. Okay. then you must give a quota that how much it can use from that table space. Even if this 2 MB is exceeded, it can still pick up more space from the system table space. So not much of a problem here. But initially, he must be granted some quota so that he can start working. And then this connect and resource are privileges, or you can say these are the two roles through which this user can do anything in his own account. Another role is a DBA. So if I simply write here grant DBA to W1, that means this user W1 is equivalent to the system user or the super user. Okay. So this was regarding creating users. So if there are any questions, you can ask. Yeah, I'm waiting for your questions. It's a good chance for you to learn the details about, you know, because normally you wouldn't find these things in book in a ready-made shape. So you need to search for them a lot. And obviously to work as a good DBA or to work with databases in an efficient manner, you should be good in databases. That would be required in all your projects, especially your part B of the lab would be dependent on this, how you create tables and how you create associations and all. Right. Okay. Let's move ahead. I think you are there, or ऐसा तो नहीं कि on करके और अभी उधर हो गए हैं. देखें तो check करें. हाँ जी शिवम, unmute कीजिए अपने आप को.
Yes sir. Morning sir.
Good morning. शिवम कहाँ चले गए थे आप? पहले आपको बुला रहे थे, हम आए नहीं आप.
Parents की call आई थी तो नीचे गया.
अच्छा अच्छा. ठीक है. सुबह भी class थी.
Morning लगाइए sir class.
वो भी क्लास थी. अच्छा चलो, काफी लंबा फिर तो शेड्यूल हो गया आपका आज का. ये समझ में आ गया क्रिएट यूजर की नहीं?
सर मैं अभी आया हूँ थोड़ी देर में.
तो ये मिस हो गया आपका, ये नहीं आपसे होगा फिर. ठीक है, मिस हो जाएगा, कोई बात नहीं. चलिए, आप तो वैसे ही अच्छे हैं डेटाबेसेस में, है ना? ठीक है, देखिए और कौन कौन बच्चे हैं आज. ऑल राइट, मेनी ऑफ यू आर देयर. रितेश राज, अनम्यूट कीजिए अपने आप को.
गुड मॉर्निंग सर.
गुड मॉर्निंग रितेश, समझ में आया कैसे बनाने यूजर्स? कैसे?
यस सर.
फाइन, ठीक, इसको ट्राई करने आप जरूर. ठीक है,
ओके
ओके. साक्षी आप बताइए बेटा.
गुड आफ्टरनून सर.
गुड आफ्टरनून, समझ में आ गया आपको क्रिएट यूजर? इसको चला के देखना जरूर, तो प्रॉब्लम आएगी तो फिर नेक्स्ट लैब सेशन में आप पूछ सकते हैं. ठीक है, ओके. सेजल आप बताइए बेटा.
यस सर.
समझ में आ गया आपको ये?
सर मेरे को लास्ट वाला जब आपने करा ना वो नहीं,
तो ये क्रिएट
यूजर W1 आइडेंटिफाई सर डिफॉल्ट टेबल स्पेस यूजर्स कोटा वाला.
हाँ, ये स्क्रीन पे ही हम देख लेते हैं, यही वाला आप बोल रहे हैं क्रिएट यूजर, ये बोल रहे हैं ना? ठीक है, सिंपली क्रिएटिंग अ यूजर डजंट अलाउ द यूजर टू क्रिएट हिज और हर ऑब्जेक्ट्स. So you must associate some table space. Table space is where the user can store his or her objects. So one table space that is already created is users. One table space is system. And we can create our own table space also with the create table space command. Okay, fine. And then we say that whatever size of that table space users is, out of that size, the user W1 can consume 2 MB, okay? And if a need arises to go beyond that 2 MB, that is added automatically from the system table space. But initially, we must allocate some quota to this user W1. Is it clear, Sejal?
Yes, sir. Okay. Sir, and when we are creating a user, we are not giving any password. So
We are writing create user W1 identified by W1. This W1, the second W1 is the password. Okay.
If I write something else, that would be my password then.
Yeah. I'll show it to you. Just have a look here. I'll show it to you. Let me connect as W1. Okay. W1/W1. This was the initial password that was given to W1. Okay. Now W1 can change the password. Okay, old password is this, new password is, so I have set a new password for user W1, okay? That is, I've kept it as triple A, okay? So let's see, W1 slash triple A. Got it, Sejan? Understood?
Yes.
Okay, fine. Chaliye, let's move ahead. This was regarding the user. I'll try to make today's session as very interesting. All of you will, you know, feel that also. So just be with me and keep on writing things, keep on taking screenshots. I've told you I won't be sharing this video immediately because I need you to work with it. So whoever, you know, whatever people are interested in doing this, I'm comfortable with that. Even if all of you are not willing to learn, that's not my headache. I can tell you everything, but you need to work on your own to be really good in this, right? So let's see now the next part of this. Let's discuss about privileges and roles in SQL, okay? So two types of privileges are there, okay? Two types of privileges are there, okay? A database privilege and a object privilege, okay? So privileges, what they do is they determine whether a user, you know, can execute a given command or a command when acting on specific groups of data. That means what access does a user have on somebody else's objects or on system privileges, that would mean a privilege, a right to use data, okay, an access to data. And usually these privileges are granted by DBA in a multi-user environment. Plus, a user can grant privileges and revoke privileges on his or her objects from another user. So two types of privileges could be there. One privilege, which is usually known as a database privilege or a system privilege, is given by the DBA to all the users in a multi-user environment. Whereas an object privilege is usually given by the owner of the object to somebody else, to some other user or users, okay? And system privileges, you know, they are the, alter, create, delete, these type of privileges. Whereas object privileges is the privilege or is the access which a user can give on his objects, okay? Okay, so how many object privileges are there? You can write. We have a select privilege. Select privilege would mean that the user can only view the data. Select would mean that the user can only view the data. Then an insert, delete, and update privilege. You know it by name. Insert, update, delete, alter. Then index, then references, then all. All would mean whatever privileges are there, everything is available to the user on a particular table. Okay. Then we have a with grant option. Now this with grant option means, let's say a user A has given a grant to user B, okay, on an object X. I repeat, a user A has given a grant to user B on an object X with a grant option. That means that B can pass it on to some other user also, right? Then if the privilege that has been granted to somebody needs to be taken back, we have a revoke command for that. Okay. And then further we have roles. Roles is a collection of related system privileges, right? So let's now see each one of these things. See it very carefully. Okay. And keep on asking questions. Okay. I'll just clear the screen from here. We already created a user. What was that? W1. Okay. We created the user W1. Let me create another user. And obviously, I'll connect as a system user to connect to create users. Okay. And then I need to do something to set that session again so that I can create a user which does not begin with the C double hash. Okay. I can copy it here. And then let me create another user. All of you please write if you wish on your copies that there is a user W1 with the password AAA. I'm going to create another user. Let's use that old command so that we don't waste time. Yeah, this W1, I'll create a user, say X1, identified by X1 and the same one, okay? So now we have two users, W1 and X1. Okay, W1 has a table P, I suppose, that we just created and inserted four values in it. This user X1 has just been created. Okay, then I need to give him something so that he can start working in his new account, grant connect comma resource to X1. Is that fine? Okay. Now let me log in as, I hope all of you are writing so that you can understand the scenario. Let me log in as W1. Okay. I've logged in as W1. Let me see how many objects are there. So select star from tab. This would mean a list of all the tables and views owned by the user W1. So only one table is there, that is with the name as P. You can see its description. Then you can see what values are there in it. Okay, so this is the table P owned by user W1. You can see which user you are logged in as. So W1 we are logged in as. Okay, now let's connect as user X1. I'm connected. If I write this, select star from P, will this work? Raise your hands, please. This is the new user that we just created, X1. I'm writing select star from P. Will this work? P is not owned by X1, it is owned by W1. So will this work, yes or no? And how this user W1 can watch the contents of table P owned by user W1. Yes, so many people are raising hands. Okay, Subhia is there. Okay. Yes, Subhia. Subhia, Sahil, Abhijit, so many people have raised hands. Yes, Subhia, go ahead.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, it will not work as P is not owned by X1.
Yeah, P is not owned by X1. So how X1 can watch the contents of P or work with P is that the user W1 can extend some privileges to him, right? Okay, Subhia, stay with me. If I write this, it will say table or view does not exist. Okay, so let me again connect as W1. Okay, and let me write here select star from P. Okay, now let me use a grant command. Grant select on P to X1. So now what user W1 is doing, that he is granting a select privilege to the user X1 on his table P. See the syntax, grant select, that is the privilege on table name to username. So if there are other users, they can be separated by commas. If W1 wants that this should be given to every user or every new user also, then we can write on P to public. Okay, I repeat, when this is written, this means that this table P can be viewed by everybody who is logged in or who logs in later or new users. So public is like if you want to grant access to everybody. Okay, yes, Abhijit, you want to ask something?
Yes, sir. Agar W1 user mein multiple table available ho sir, aur hum usko kya grant dena chahte hain P, matlab another X1 user mein, matlab sare table ko main copy karna chahta hu, to uske liye kya use karenge? Select grant select on.
I have not understood your question. Go slow on your question.
W1 user mein multiple tables hai, more than one table hai sir.
Theek hai, maan lete hain unme teen table hai, P, Q, R. Fir आपको बारी बारी करना पड़ेगा मेरे ख्याल से. हम करके देख सकते हैं, बट मेरे ख्याल से आपको सिलेक्ट ऑन P कॉमा वो करके देख सकते हैं आप. ठीक है, आप ये कह रहे हैं ना कि ऐसा नहीं कर सकते
मतलब?
हाँ, इंडिविजुअली मेरे को लगता है देना पड़ेगा, आप चेक कर लीजिएगा इसको क्रिएट करके. ठीक है, you need to give it individually, but user names can be given like this. You can give username like x1 comma s1 comma w1 like this. Okay, So right now we just write it. We'll discuss this in today's session, don't worry, but let's go slow. User W1 is extending a view or a select privilege on its table P to the user X1, right? This has succeeded, right? Now let's connect as X1. Okay, use the same command now. Again, it says this. What needs to be done, Subhia? Okay, Sahil has raised hands. Yeah, Subhia, you just wait. Sahil, raise your hand again, please. Yeah. Yes, Sahil. Sahil, your voice is not clear. It's not completely audible. Let's ask Sejal. She has raised hand. Yes, Sejal. Sejal, raise your hands again. Yeah. Yes. Please answer, Sejal.
So we need to copy that table first.
No need to copy. Once there is a privilege, so you answered a good thing. Maybe it's incorrect, but that puts us on a discussion. So you say that the table needs to be copied. No, the table is owned by W1. So the table name should be preceded before the object name. This is the correct syntax. Now what we are trying to do is that the user X1 is trying to view the table P owned by W1. So he must write W1.P. Okay. And if the privilege is there, you will see the answer. Is it correct, Sejal? So have all of you, Sejal, you are not audible. You are speaking, but you are not audible. Okay. Some problem with your mic or sound maybe. So have all of you understood this thing that since this user, we are logged in as user X1. This X1 had a privilege on the table P owned by W1. To view its content, we must precede the table name by the username. Okay. Now let me try another thing. What will this command do? Raise your hands. What will this command do? What I'm trying to do here? Yeah, this is a very simple question. If you participate, that would be good. Okay, Prince Kumar wants to answer. Abhijit has also raised hands. Yes, Prince.
It is expecting to delete P table from the user.
Yeah, it's expecting to delete not the P table, but all the rows from the P table. P table would be there, but all the data would be removed if we use this.
Yes,
command,
yes,
right?
Sir. All the rows will be gone.
But will this work, Prince? Let's ask Sachin.
Yes,
Sachin.
Yes, sir.
It will work. Okay, fine. Yes, Sachin.
Yes, sir.
Will it work, Sachin?
No, sir, because command is not granted. Delete command.
Delete command is, yeah, very good. So the privilege delete is not granted. We just granted, you can see, I'll just scroll the screen up. We just gave this grant select on P. Okay, and I told you that there are many privileges, as you can see here. You can see the privileges, alter, delete, select, insert, all these privileges are there. So, but we have just granted the select privilege. Okay, so even if we just press enter here, it will say insufficient privileges. Okay, it says insufficient privileges because the delete privilege is not available with the user X1. I hope it's clear to all of you. If it is clear what grant can do and how we can, you know, use it, you can raise your hands, all of you. If you've understood how we can grant privileges, okay. Okay, let's now connect again as W1. Okay, and grant this privilege, grant select, comma, insert, comma, delete. Now I've granted three privileges to X1 on the table P. Okay, and then let's go back as user X1. Okay, and let's now delete W1.P. Will it work now? Raise your hands. the grant has been given, it has succeeded. So X1 can view the table P, can insert something in the table P, can delete something from the table P. So will it work? Let's ask Abhijit. Yes, Abhijit.
Yes, sir, it will work. It will delete all rows.
So it will delete four rows. User. So we see four rows deleted. Okay. So four rows deleted. Now, have the rows been removed permanently, Abhijit?
From X1 user, yes, sir. It is terminated from X1 user, sir.
Okay, somebody else to answer this question. Abhijit says that once this command is given, this is permanently deleted. Somebody else to answer? Okay, Sejal wants to answer. Yes, Sejal.
Sir, it won't permanently delete if we didn't commit.
Yeah, so since this is a DML command, DML command is insert, delete, update. So this is not deleted. If I just write rollback, first I will show you. First, we'll see whether, you know. So first, let's write this. How many rows would be displayed, Abhijit?
Four, sir.
Zero rows. Because you have already deleted.
Okay.
No rows. But if you want to retain these rows, you just write rollback. Rollback is any work that you've done in this session is rolled back. Okay. So this delete would be undone. Okay. Rollback complete. Now, if you watch the rows, they are back. So till the time you write commit or you exit this SQL prompt with the exit command, your DML commands are not affected. Okay. Let's now insert into this table P. So once again, insert into w1.p values, say I can write here 60. Okay. And if you select now, that has been added also. So the user can select, can insert, can delete. Okay. Let's now connect again as w1. Okay. And watch whether this row has been added here. You can see the row has been inserted. Okay. Now, let me revoke some privileges. Revoke is to take back, okay? So basically here I'm dealing with the object privileges, okay? So I'm going to revoke this privilege. Revoke, say, delete on P from X1. Just see the syntax here, simple. See the difference between grant and revoke. Revoke is to take back the privilege. So you write revoke, then you take, write the privilege name, then the object name, and then from whom you want to revoke the privilege. Okay. So now with this, what this user X1 has with him, he was granted these three things in the previous, when we wrote this command, select, insert, delete. He was granted this. Now you have taken back the delete. So he can only insert and select. Let's see whether the revoke has been taken back or not. So let's connect again as the user X1. Okay. And let's simply try this delete command in one, because delete has been revoked. So let's see whether it works or not. So I'm writing delete w1.p. Once again, it will say insufficient privileges because this privilege has been taken back. Okay. Now one interesting, let me just show you one database privilege. Okay. So this has to be given by the DBA. Okay. So remember the scenario, there are two users, W1 and X1. Okay. So now I connect as the super user with my system login. Okay. Now, if I ask you, if you are in a multi-user environment, say we have Abhijit, we have Sejal, two users. Okay. Now, Sejal is busy working on something. She asks Abhijit, can you create a table in my account? My question is this possible? Raise your hands. Can one user create a table or an object in another user's account? Raise your hands to answer this very interesting question. You just need to say yes or no. I repeat the question. Can one user create an object, like a table or a view, in another user's account? Okay, let's see a new person answering. Ankit Prakash. Okay. Yes, Ankit, go ahead.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Yes.
Sir, one user can create a table for the other user.
Yeah, while one user is logged into his own account, can he create a table or a view or any other object into another user's account? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
How?
Sir, firstly, he or she will create that table in his own account.
No, not that way. You know, he gives a create table command and the table is stored in the other user's account. Yes, Prince can answer this.
Sir, if we are given the permission from the user.
How is that given? User can only give object privileges. That is, user can give privileges on the objects created by him. Okay, I'll answer this. Let's try this, okay? The DBA can give this power to a user to create something into some other user's account. How this is possible, okay? Have a look, all of you, on screen. I am logged in as, kindly see, I'm logged in as system. Now, raise your hands to answer this question. Did W1 grant anything to the user system? Raise your hands to answer this question. Did the user W1 grant anything to the user system? Yes, Prince?
Not yet, sir.
Not yet. So can system view the P table of user W1, Prince?
I guess no.
Okay. Anyone else who wants to answer this question? Okay, Ankit Prakash wants to answer. Go ahead, Ankit.
Yes, sir, it can view. But firstly, it must import that table.
No, just forget about this import and copy, all of you, okay? The simple question is, the system user has not been granted anything by the user W1 on his table P. The question is whether system can watch or work with the table P. Yes or no? Prince said no. Yes, Ankit?
You can't say.
Okay, let's see it. Let's see it and then we'll discuss why this happens. See, system is a super user. He does not need any permission from any user. Okay, system जो है वो किसी का password भी change कर सकता है, किसी को delete भी कर सकता है, block भी कर सकता है. देखिए, system, I'm logged in as system. I'm changing the password of W1 from AAA to something else. See, the system is not able to see the password. He doesn't know the password of the user W1. But he can override it. He can change it. See how? Kindly note this also. He sets the new password. This is in case the user W1 forgets his password. The system can always retrieve it back. So he says, alter the user identified by ABC. So now the user has been altered. So if you now want to connect with W1, the password is ABC. So remember, system can work with objects of any user that are there in the environment. If this thing is clear to all of you, kindly raise your hands. Then we'll come back to our basic question. Yeah, raise your hands. That's a good exercise for all of you. Very good. Very good. All right. Fine. Lower your hands now. Now the other question. Okay. The question again was whether one user can create an object into another user's account. Okay. So let's first see how I'm logged in. Okay. Let me log in as system. Now let's work with a database privilege. See the grant now. The grant name is, which is a system or a database privilege, create any table. So what the system is saying that the user W1 can create any table into anybody's account. Interesting. Let's see whether it works or not. So I'll log in as user W1 now, and I'll create a table in user X1. See, I'll log in as user W1. Okay. And I'll create a table for user X1. See how? Because I have the privilege. So I should write X1 dot say student. I'm creating a table student into the account of the user X1. Okay. Sorry. So we have a role number and a name, two columns I have taken, and then this. See, table has been created. But let's see if I write here describe student. He'll say object does not exist because this user W1 has created this object for user X1 into X1's account. And he was able to do this because of this grant given to him, the system grant, database privilege given by the administrator to him. Create any table. वो किसी के अकाउंट में भी जाके टेबल क्रिएट कर सकता है. Let's check कि ये हुआ भी है कि नहीं. So let's connect as X1 and let's see here describe student. Good. Something new that you've learned today. The power of the administrator or the power of the DBA. Okay. So there are many create any privileges. You can just have a Google on it or you can search from some book. I've shown you how it works. Okay, fine. So let's have a 2 minutes break. Okay. So let's now work with the roles. You can see is a collection of system privileges. So you've just seen the three roles, the standard system roles. You can create your own roles also if you wish. The three system roles are connect, resource and DBA. You know the meanings for them. Connect would allow a new user to log in. Resource would allow him to create his objects. And DBA would allow him to do anything in the environment. Okay. So if I say grant DBA to some username, then that user becomes the DBA. Is equivalent to the system user or the super user. Okay. Okay. Now let's discuss about, okay, we don't have anything here. Yeah, did we see the with grant option? I think it's clear to all of you, but if you wish, we can work with that. But then we need to create another user for it. Okay, we can create another user. Let's see. Say we create a user Y1. Let's go back where we can find a create user statement. But then first we need to connect as a system, right? So connect as system. I'm going to show you the with grant option, right? So let's write it instead of searching, create user Y1 identified by Y1 default table space. With practice, you don't need to memorize these commands. Default table space, you can write as users. Then you can write quota 3m on users. That's a command. Okay. Yeah, we need to reset that privilege, right? That's the thing, the problem here. So you can write this thing sort of thing here. This won't work. Session is altered. Now our command can work that we wrote. We created a new user. Then we can grant connect comma resource to Y1. So Y1 can now create the objects. He can log in. Okay. And Okay, now let's see a scenario. We go back to user W1. Kindly pay attention, all of you. This would be interesting. We go to W1 with an ABC, I suppose. Yeah. And you know there is an object P. Okay. So let me grant something. Grant delete on P to X1. Okay. And remember, insert and select are already granted. They were not revoked. Okay. So now X1, we wanted to add with grant option. Okay. Now what W1 has done is, given a grant on his table P to X1, and he says that you can further grant this option to somebody else also. That is the meaning of with grant option. So let's now log in as X1 to see whether this is true. Okay, and let's let X1 grant something. Grant, say, delete on P to Y1. Raise your hands. This is correct. Very interesting question. You should be able to answer this, most of you. Will this work? See the hierarchy here. Okay, Prince, wait, I'll ask you. This W1 granted delete on P to X1 with the grant option. That means this delete option was granted to X1 and he can further it to somebody else also. So I did it. I logged in as X1 and I wrote grant delete on P to Y1. Will it work? Raise your hands. Somebody raise hands. Okay, Abhijit Kumar. Yes, go ahead. Prince also.
It will work, sir.
It will work. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Okay. Prince, you can answer.
Yes, sir, it should.
It should, but you people are not careful. It won't. See, it won't. See, X1 is not the owner of P. Okay, so what we are missing here is the owner always comes before the table name. So what X1 is trying to do, grant a delete on the table P owned by W1 to Y1. Because he is able to do this because he has been given this with grant option. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now it will work. Now it will work. Oh. Okay. Got it now with grant option? All right. Let's work something with the alter table command. I'm expecting you people to help me in that. Raise your hands who would be willing to help me with some alter table scenarios. Nothing difficult, normal alter table options. I'm connected as user this, and there is a table P. I would ask you to do some alterations for this. We have discussed this already in the class, but since it's a lab session, so it might be interesting. Nobody is willing. You people are so tired. You are young minds. You don't want to participate into something new. 658 people are logged in. Nobody is willing to answer. Why that's so? Raise your hands who want to participate. Some girl students maybe. Okay. Rhythm, unmute yourself.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, beta. Yes, Vani, unmute yourself.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Vani, help me to add another column name into this table P using the alter table command. Try it. Even if you don't answer, there's no problem, okay? Rhythm, aap bhi sochiye and Vani, you'll answer. मुझे एक कॉलम ऐड करना है टेबल पी में. टेबल बन चुका है पहले, ठीक है. उसके अंदर एक कॉलम ऐड करना है नेम. कर सकते हैं वानी? नहीं कर सकते. ओके रिदम, कैन यू ट्राई? ऑल राइट. ओके सी हु आर द पीपल हु कैन ट्राई. ओके सलिल, चंदन, अभिजीत, Subhia. Let's go with Subhia. Subhia, a bit louder, okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, still your voice is not very clear. Yeah, Rhythm, you want to say something?
Sir, I want to try.
Go ahead. Boliye.
Alter table P.
देखो आपको आता है लेकिन आप ट्राई नहीं करते हो पूरा नहीं भी आया तो क्या हो गया ऑल्टर टेबल पी
नेम
नो यू सी नो 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 लिसन 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 लेट्स लर्न हाउ टू डू इट रिदम ऑल्टर टेबल पी नो व्हाट ऑल्टरेशन नीड्स टू बी डन डू वी नीड टू ऐड समथिंग डू वी नीड टू मॉडिफाई समथिंग डू वी नीड टू डिलीट समथिंग क्या करना है बताइए ऐड करना है ना
यस सर
तो ऐड लिखना पड़ेगा ठीक है
फिर एड नेम वेयर
ये लिख दें मुझे पता yes. नहीं मैं ऐसे लिख के देखते हैं हो गया तो हो गया ठीक yes. है हो गया ना देखो कितना इजी था हो गया नेम की नहीं व्हाट वाज द प्रॉब्लम ठीक है गुड आंसर रिदम वेरी गुड चलिए अब रोल नंबर को प्राइमरी की बनाना है रेज योर हैंड्स ये तो इजी है See, if you work on things like this, only then you'd be able to work with tables later on, with projects later on. ये आपको करना ही पड़ेगा. So kindly see how it should be done. Now syntax थोड़ा बहुत database के हिसाब से change हो जाएगा. Doesn't matter. Yes, raise your hands. How we can make role, which is a normal column, as a primary key column? Remember, it has been the table has been created already. Okay, Abhijit wants to try. Some other people should also raise hands. Shivam से पूछते हैं शिवम आप कहाँ चले गए Yes, Shivam. So, Abhijit, Ritesh, yes, they have raised hands. Yes, Shivam, बताइए बेटा You can answer this, I suppose. Role को primary की बना दीजिए No, Shivam, you can't do it?
No, sir.
Shivam, मेरे को लगता है यू आर मच मोर इंटेलिजेंट यू नो यू शुड बी एबल टू आंसर दिस इजी क्वेश्चन चलिए ठीक है कोई बात नहीं अंकित प्रकाश यू कैन आंसर दिस
यस सर सर फर्स्टली ऑल्टर टेबल ऐड कॉन्स्टेंट
ऐड कर दो ठीक है
ऐड कॉन्स्टेंट रोल नंबर
No, no, no. We are not on right track. You stay with me, Ankit. Okay, I'll ask you again. Salil Chandan wants to answer. Abhijit, आपके पास भी आ रहा हूँ.
Sir, add table P. Oh, sorry, alter table P.
Yeah.
Add primary key bracket roll number.
Yeah, this would be an easier way. Roll, right? The name of the column is roll.
Roll.
This is one way. I'm coming back to you. Who was answering prior to this? Raise your hands. Ankit Prakash, आप बोल रहे थे? Ankit, unmute कीजिए अपने आप को.
Yes, yes sir.
You were answering before.
Yes sir.
ठीक है. एक तो yes. ये एक syntax ये चल जाएगा Ankit. अब आप जो बोल रहे हैं वो लिख लेते हैं.
Okay sir.
ताकि आप देखें ठीक है कि नहीं बोलिए.
Sir, add constant. primary key bracket roll number
ये नहीं चलेगा ठीक है मैं आपको बता रहा हूँ ये नहीं चलेगा somebody can tell us ये क्यों नहीं चलेगा maybe Salil बता देंगे क्यों नहीं चलेगा yes Salil
sir constant name is not given हाँ
very good see ये word add है अगर आपको constraint को नाम देना है okay then you write the word constraint Then you write the name for the constraint. Then you write primary key roll number. Okay? I'll modify this as told by Ankit. Ankit ne ye miss kar gaye Ankit. Maybe pry underscore roll. This is a complete way now. You are adding a constraint and you are giving the constraint a name. Fine? Okay?
Yes,
sir. Okay? Agar isko drop karna ho, अब अभिजीत आप रेज कीजिए हैंड यस अभिजीत यस वेरी गुड प्लीज आंसर आई वांट टू ड्रॉप दिस कंस्ट्रेंट अभिजीत जो मैंने अभी लगाया है या बोलिए
अल्टर टेबल अल्टर टेबल बी सर ड्रॉप और प्राइमरी की भी लिख सकते हैं सर ड्रॉप प्राइमरी की
या इजी वे वुड बी बिकॉज़ एक टेबल में एक ही प्राइमरी की होती है सिंपली ड्रॉप प्राइमरी की बट क्योंकि हमने कंस्ट्रेंट को नाम दिया हुआ है हम इसको ऐसे भी लिख सकते हैं. काइंडली नोट ऑल ऑफ यू, ड्रॉप कंस्ट्रेंट, आगे कंस्ट्रेंट का नाम लिख दीजिए. ठीक है, ऐसे लिखने से भी ड्रॉप हो जाएगी. फिर से लगाएं कंस्ट्रेंट, देखें ताकि आपको पता चल जाए कितने तरीके हैं लगाने के, क्योंकि प्राइमरी की एक ही होती है, उसको कंस्ट्रेंट को नाम दो चाहे ना दो चलता है. सो ऑल्टर टेबल पी एड प्राइमरी की, दिस वर्क्स. और जब ड्रॉप करना है तो इजी है, कुछ लिखने की जरूरत नहीं. ड्रॉप
ओनली प्राइमरी की,
ड्रॉप प्राइमरी की, दैट्स इट. तो इसी तरह से यू कैन वर्क विद ऑल्टर टेबल, शुड नॉट बी अ प्रॉब्लम आई थिंक. आप इस पे काम कर सकते हैं. I think that should be the end of today's session because you already had English, I think, English class, I suppose. And English class thi, koi aur class thi? Ki operating system thi? Okay, Prince wants to say, yeah. Yes, Prince?
Operating system,
fine. So let me...